Good morning, everyone. Look at Elias in the bed.
Still haven't been out of bed yet.
Literally. So we're packing right now because we're actually going to be taking the train. It's called the Thalys train. And we're taking it to Brussels right now to rent a car to go to the countryside where we'll be staying with my family.
We are going to take the train and we're going to drive.
And we're going to drive. All right, guys. So see you on the floor. We got to go catch this train.
Bye.
Bye. Say bye. Bye, bye, bye. Oh my God, it's going down. The whip. Driving in Brussels, Belgium right now, and we're heading to a small little town called Warizy, and that's where we'll be staying for our trip, well, part of our trip, and then we'll come back in Brussels later on in the week. How do you get money for this? Get out of here, we're at a red light, and he's giving us his show. Nice. No, I don't. Yes. Oh, he picked up the broken floor. Hey, I don't have anything. What? Don't hit nobody's car now. What? Cute. I'm like blown away. It's like something in a movie. So we made it to my aunt's house. The summer house is beautiful. It's so rustic. It's so our style. Look at this little crib. This is like a makeshift, like little crib for Elias. Yeah, this is so cute. So our whole family comes here for the month. There's like millions of rooms. This is where the girls stay. It's so cute. Backyard. I'm just so in awe with this place. It's so sweet. Now we're gonna go for a walk in the little village.
Good town.
It's gonna be so cute. I feel like I'm in a dream, yeah. I feel like I'm in a dream. Oh, love. Come see me something, no, love. Like, it's beautiful, like a nice dream. Ooh, there's a bee next to my hand. Oui. You say hi? Oui. Okay. This is my aunt. Say hi, my aunt.
And my Uncle Alfred.
So the name of this place is called Walizi. Mm-hmm. It's a small little village outside of Brussels, about an hour and a half. And it's the cutest little place. It's so peaceful and we're walking in the street. There's no cars. No cars. It's just calm and peaceful. It's a cute little village. I'm so glad we came. Yeah, it's sour. Mm, this smells good. They're so good. It's good. Oh, okay. Baby, look at this. Look at your lights. It's so cute. What's Pat? No.
Pat, good morning.
Good morning.
So we woke up late today.
Yeah.
By default, because of this kid over here.
Bye.
He was like running around in the bed. He climbed on top of my head.
Mine as well.
And he just literally just running around the whole bed with his eyes closed. So it was fun.
Yeah.
But he got some sleep. But we didn't get much sleep.
It's okay though.
But that's the joy of parenthood. But we just ate breakfast. We about to head out.
Good breakfast.
See
the smallest town in the world.
The smallest town in the world. We'll get that for you.
I don't know. It's the smallest town in the world. So, and it's in Belgium. So we're going to stop by and see it. Yeah. And life Wi-Fi-less has been okay.
I'm okay.
I've been all right.
I don't mind being off the grid.
We're like legitimately off the grid. We can't even make phone calls.
No calls. No connection. But we have family, so there's no point of us.
Right. And the nearest hospital is 2 hours away. So hopefully I won't get a bug stuck in my ear.
Yeah.
Taina. That's Taina. Taina. Woosh. Taina.
Maisha.
Not Moesha. I said Moesha. Maisha. Sayel. That I'll know. I will remember this one. Taina. Maisha. Guys, aren't my cousins beautiful? Oh, they speak French only. Tu parles français seulement. Nous parlons Flemish? Flemish? No? Okay. Creole? Je comprends pas. My French cousin. Alrighty. Oh, and côté nous parler. Du bruit. Du bruit, guys. Du bruit. Dieu.
Bui.
Oui.
You like noise.
Oui.
Bui.
Oui.
You like noise.
Yeah, no, please. Bui.
Yeah, but you have to do with the accent.
Oui. Because it's B-U-Y-E. Like right? B-U-Y-E. Not D-U-B. No.
On that note.
Okay, on y va. Allons-y. It's literally the smallest town in the world. That's what it's known for. But it's so beautiful. Check it out. Oui. So, we are top of some tower in Dubuque, and we're out of breath because we have to walk up here.
Entire tower.
Yeah, but you can you have a panoramic view, and you can see parts of Luxembourg, they said. I just don't know what part.
Which area was left or right.
So we're just gonna pan and show you. Oh, gentlemen, the smallest town in the whole wide world. Right here. Look at that cliff. It's amazing. Try it, Elias. Go ahead. We have to come back. This place is the best.
So far,
two thumbs up for sure.
Especially this trip.
Yeah.
Great, great.
You guys, I've said this before. Every time we travel, something dramatic happens to me. So Puerto Rico, I got a bug in my ear, right? And I came out. This time in Belgium, I'm walking and talking and a bug flies right in my mouth. I was like, real quick. It was like a full bug. Only me, only my luck.
Confession. I love this place.
Yeah.
Like, ridiculously love this place. It's quiet. It's family oriented. Elias is like enjoying himself. picking out, I don't know, leaves and whatever's on the floor.
That's all
it's not. It's not right. So he's just like roaming around. Look at this. And it's quiet. Everybody's enjoying themselves. Yes. Over there, the girls are like playing.
This is the definition of family time.
This is so
this
cool.
This is my family's summer house in Belgium. It's just so, why have I not come sooner?
Yeah, we need to invest. Oh, Elias left. He's gone. We should be able to enjoy this. But we can't limit ourselves. I'm praying that my family start doing stuff like that. You know? We need to do stuff like that. I want to do stuff like that for myself and for my family, my son, so we can like enjoy this every summer, man.
Every summer. Everyone should go to Belgium.
Belgium, wherever it is, I don't care. Even in Haiti, we could rent a place. I don't care. But just not limit ourselves.
Yeah.
You know, we should do this every summer. It's only for a month. Only for a month.
Bravo.
No? Okay. Oh wait, before you go, my goodness, people, their cat, you saw, listen, he tore up a mouth. Oh my god. He ate half of it. Oh my god, the guts. What? Babe, he ate the mouse.
Oh,
I've never seen it. What's his name again?
I don't know the cat's name, but it tore up that mouse. It's
pure savagery.
Pure savagery.
It was a hot mess. He was playing with it, just boop, 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 boop. I was like, oh, he's just going to play with the mouse. He's not going to hurt it.
Gobbled that up.
That mouse couldn't even move. He injured 3 out of 4 limbs. And then next thing you know, I saw literally like a transverse sectional. Like you can see meat and a bone. Like his spine, like that cat tore that thing. I couldn't believe it. And he was licking his paws and he was done.
They were in shock. I was like, you guys don't see this every day? Like, this is a nature channel in person. It's the wild.